Hi, this is Soumya from the team Smart Dustbin Monitoring System with the email notification. This is our team leader, J. Sai Kumar, and this is T. Haimavati, and this is J. Tejashwini, and this is R. Praveen.
Hello, now I'm going to explain about our project. Our project is about the Smart Dustbin Monitoring System. It is an IoT-based Smart Dustbin Monitoring System where real-time garbage bin levels can be monitored through the internet. And the requirements are of two types, hardware requirements and software requirements. And the hardware requirements are NodeMCU version 1.0, USB cable, jumper wires, and ultrasonic sensor, RGB LED. And the software requirements are Arduino IDE and ESP8266 libraries, UV.s free account, and UV.s libraries. Now I am going to explain about the installation of libraries. Now we have to change the board manager into the NodeMCU. Now you copy this link, open Arduino IDE, and go to the preferences. Now you paste the link in the additional board manager URLs, click on OK, then go to the tools and board Arduino, boards manager, then now search for the ESP8266, click on install. Now the board is installing and the installation is completed. Now go to the tools menu, boards Arduino and ESP8266 boards, and then search for NodeMCU version 1.0 and ESP12E module and select it. Now I'm going to explain about the installation of UV.s libraries. For downloading, click on this link, then go to sketch, include library, and add a zip library. Search in the downloads and the downloaded file is here, and click on choose.
I'm gonna explain about the circuit diagram and the block diagram in this project. We are interfacing the ultrasonic sensor and the RGB LED common anode with the NodeMCU. HC-SR4 ultrasonic sensor works on 5 volts, so if you connect it to the 3 volts, it doesn't work. VCC pin of the ultrasonic sensor is connected to the VCC pin of NodeMCU, where the trigger and echo pins are connected to the D5 and D6 of the NodeMCU, while the ground pin is connected to the ground of the NodeMCU, and this pin is connected to the lead anode, and D3, D2 and D1 are connected to the 3 remaining pins of LED of 5 volts. Power supply is connected to the NodeMCU, and this is the block diagram in where the trigger and echo is connected to D5 and D6, and we will connect the NodeMCU with a 5 volts power supply. Thank you.
Hello, in this section I will tell you how to create a free UV.s account. In order to create the account, navigate to the following link, copy the link and paste it in your browser. Then provide your username, email ID and password and sign up for free account. After that, click on next and click on go to my dashboard. It is our demo dashboard, and if you click on the user icon and click on API credentials, and API key and token are the API keys that we use in our code to send data to the cloud. And now we are navigating to our main UV.s account so that I can show you how we implemented the dashboard. In order to add a new widget, click on add new widget and select the widget that you like or suitable for your project, and then click on add variable. Then select the variable that the code in your Arduino is sending to the cloud. In our case, level is the variable that the NodeMCU is sending to the cloud. After that, name your widget and click on OK. We need to create an event so that if the dashboard is full, we get an email notification. In order to do that, click on events, and here is our event. And if you want to create a new event, click create new event and enter the value at which the event should be triggered. Click next and then click add action, and actions are of different kinds. We are going with send an email. enter the email ID of the person who should receive the email notification, and then enter the subject and the message of the email ID. After filling that, click on next and next and next. The event is created and it will be triggered when the event is occurred. Hello everyone, in this section I will explain you the code that we wrote for our project. Initially we are including the required libraries for our project, and next we are configuring the Wi-Fi and API details. The ubitot token is the API key that we are provided with when we create a free account in ubitot cloud. Wi-Fi SSID and Wi-Fi pass are the Wi-Fi name and Wi-Fi password of the network for what our node MCU is should connect and use. In this line, we are connecting to the ubitot cloud with provided API key using HTTP protocol. And here, we are configuring the ultrasonic sensor trigger and echo pins to D5, D6 pins of our node MCU. We are also declaring three variables to store duration, distance and level. And we are also setting red, green, blue to D1, D2, D3 pins of our node MCU. And bin length is a variable which stores the length of our dustbin. In the setup, we are setting the pin mode of our trigger pin to output and our echo pin to input. We are starting our serial monitor from here. In this line, we are connecting to Wi-Fi with the provided Wi-Fi name and password. And here, we are setting the pin mode of our red, green, blue to output. In the loop, we are initially setting the trigger pin to low and we are waiting for 2 microseconds. And then we are setting the trigger pin to high and again we are waiting for 10 milliseconds. And then we are setting it to low. By this, we are getting the duration with this code and we are calculating the distance with the formula distance equals to speed into time. And we are printing the distance to serial monitor. And with this line, we are calculating the level at which our dustbin is filled. And also, we are printing it to the serial monitor. From here, we are checking the level of our dustbin so that we can print the corresponding RGB light. If the level is greater than or equals to 75, we are glowing red light and we are printing light equals to red to our serial monitor. Likewise, if the level is in between 40 and 75, we are glowing the blue light, and if it is below 45, we are glowing the green light. And then we are adding level and level value to our ubitot and we are sending it to the cloud. If the send is successful, we will print value sent by the device to cloud to the serial monitor, and the loop starts again.
Hello everyone, myself Pravin, and now I am going to explain that my project.
This is node MCU and this is ultrasonic sensor and this is RGB LED.
Now look at here, the bucket is empty, you can see, and the bucket is empty position, the green light will glow. And look at here,
the bucket is empty, that's the person is zero level. Now we can fill that bucket.
See here, we have to fill in that bonus graph on the bucket. We have the level is increasing. The level is increasing.
Now look at here once. The level is increased to 65%, and here the light will glow blue color. Finally, we see that the red light will glow, the light, the LED is glow, that light. And the percentage will be increased